Last full day of Comic-Con for me, for you guys. We're here with two of my favorites, Sam and Kat. It's good to see you guys.
Great
good to see
you again.
You too. Yeah.
We took a one-year hiatus, all of us, from each other at least.
I feel like we needed that just to get over what happened before.
Well, 2 years ago we all met for the first time, so we started to build a relationship, and since then I've seen both of you individually, but it's not the we need the gang all back together.
Yeah. I know. This is good. I mean, we're working through our issues. We like this. This is good.
Well, we talk about the big reunion between Jamie and Claire. I feel the big reunion is the three of us that needs to
happen.
This is the real love triangle.
It's the triangle that we don't mention in the show. Yeah, but.
Exactly. So talk to about coming back here to Comic-Con, a bit of a different environment, I would think, on the third season, the second go-around for you. You knew what you were getting out of Comic-Con, what the kind of reception would be, but is it similar to that last time, or what? Give me a sense.
I think the first time we came here in season one, it was just, I don't know. I mean, you just don't know what's happening. You sort of just go from room to room and people are shouting, but you don't know why and they don't know why. But I think now it's nice. We've worked really hard on this season. We're really proud of it. So it's nice to bring it here.
We feel like the salty old school, like.
You feel like a salty old school?
I feel like salty old school.
Oh, like, yeah.
They wheel us out now. Like, there's all these young shows walking around.
He's been
around.
On a boat. It's just all, naval references now.
Yes. And, absolutely. It's nice to come back. It feels like we kind of know what we're doing, maybe.
You almost got through that.
We so know what we're doing.
And the actual panel, you surprised the audience with the first episode,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So that you knew you were going in.
They lost their minds.
I'm sure.
Cool. Yeah.
So give me a sense of, let's talk a little bit about what's coming up in this season, because there's a lot to look forward to. Of course, we've heard by now that we're not going to see you two together immediately. How long do we have to wait?
20 years.
Well, okay. That's accurate, I suppose.
Yeah.
I don't know if we can say exactly when the reunion happens, but it's not that long.
Okay.
It's definitely not half and half, let's say that way.
Well, so when you approach one of those scenes that you know the fans in particular are going to be, like, looking forward to and seeing sort of how it compares with the books, is there a different environment on set? Are there different conversations? Does it feel like, okay, let's not bring our usual D game. Let's bring the A game today.
Yeah, it is mostly D game.
No.
To be honest, we're very aware. There are these key moments in the show and in the books that fans kind of look forward to, and I think every season has them.
Yeah.
And this, again, was probably, one of them. And I know
in some ways, maybe this is the wrong way to approach it, but in some ways I almost do the opposite.
Because
I think you don't want to
put pressure on
try
it.
And play for the reaction.
Yep.
You want to make sure that you're just doing what you need to do for the character. So
right.
You try and forget that it's so iconic or that so many people are going to be waiting for it, because I think then you'll just put pressure on yourself. And
It will feel less natural or whatever.
Yeah,
it'll
feel less organic.
It's such a, the episodes or the sort of storyline before as well, there's such a great build up to this moment. Our characters go on this great journey, so it feels like it's like the natural progression. You're not sort of waiting for this moment. It's just, there's so much that happens.
Do you want to give us a sneak peek of how the moment plays out just with sitting here on the couch?
Sam, just fall over.
Okay, yeah. It's basically me just falling off the couch. He does have a strange reaction and gracefully faints, I think is written in the books. But so you might get to see that.
Okay.
But it's some graceful.
It's graceful as an elephant.
As a gazelle.
At this point, having worked with each other for a few years, do you know the secret to kind of breaking each other on set? How to push each other's buttons in terms of what will set the other off?
I think so.
Yeah.
So what's the key?
Definitely breaking you is probably.
Sam tries his best to break me.
I actually, in our last episode of the season, I managed
you
to
busted
like
my nose.
Bust your nose open, which I think is healed.
It's still a little
That's
scar.
Why you've got this new fringe.
Yes, exactly. It's hiding. It's hiding my war wounds.
How did this go down?
Without saying too much, he was.
I guided her into a bit of wood.
Yes,
yeah.
Guided me quite forcefully into a piece of wood.
Okay.
He also, there was a scene this season where we were sort of having an argument, and Sam likes to sometimes push, and I think I went flying and landed on the other side of the room on my ass and couldn't walk properly for about 3 days.
So, yeah.
I think I
had your revenge yet? I mean, what I was thinking just sort of like cracking the other person up, but you were talking about actually like literally breaking the other person in half.
No,
she does actually get her revenge a lot.
No, because I just giggle on his tapes
giggler
all the time.
And she will just turn her back to the camera. So I have to continue while she's just blatantly laughing at me.
I do tend to, once I start the giggles, I just sort of turn away from camera so they can still use the,
very smart,
the clip. And Sam's just like, stop it.
Yeah. Are you looking forward to the eventual day when you stop doing the show so you can stop pretending to enjoy each other's company and just sort of end this charade?
Yes. I mean, that ends once we walk out the door.
I noticed. When they walked in, they walked in from different sides, no eye contact.
You've got two different teams.
It
like,
was really strange.
I think it's we're so fortunate. I would hate to hate the person I worked with.
That can't be
it's
a fun situation.
It's only a mild dislike.
I'm trying.
Low ebb, kind of burning hate. Yeah. Nothing too horrible though.
No, I do you know what? I mean, it's been a great journey, and I'm working on another job at the moment, and it's actually made me appreciate and realize
and
how.
And I'm working with two amazing women.
Whatever,
Mila
Kunis and Kay McKinnon, whatever.
I mean, they're just gorgeous and funny and talented.
Point, but I might not make it. It made me realize what a great show Outlander is and how lucky I am to work with Katrina.
Wait, so are you dissing your new job or are you dissing me?
This is a no-win situation for Sam. What are we doing to him? Well, that actually brings up something. I mean, what would you like to see the now that you know kind of like the talents of your friend and co-star here, like what kind of role would you want to see Sam in or Kat in outside of Outlander?
I mean, I'm dying to see this film he's doing.
It's a wild comedy,
he told me he got
like.
The job and it was probably, I said, wait, can you do comedy?
Instilled me full of confidence.
Have you signed the papers yet? Because it's not too late. You can.
He's going to be amazing.
I'd like to see you do
see
like an action film. I think something where you're like.
Well, that's because you know how clumsy I am.
That'd be amazing. So we're here at Comic-Con. Who's the sexiest superhero in all of Comic-Con?
In all of the land.
In all of the land.
There's so many of them now, aren't there? I mean.
I can only, I swear to God, when I think superhero, it's like, I'm like, wait, Superman, Batman?
Yeah, the basics. The
Spider-Man.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Fair. I mean.
Which one's sexy? Superman. Superman's pretty sexy.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
Big, strong dude.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the only thing that kills him is something that you can only find in a faraway planet. I mean, that's pretty good.
You're making a good argument.
That's a good argument. He's a classic.
When you guys now watch other films with, like, romantic scenes, and in particular, like, sex scenes, do you watch it now with, like, a more critical eye? Like, oh, yeah, I've done that move. I know how to do that. Like, yeah, I've been there.
Or like, ooh, steal that.
Yeah, we should use that.
You're like watching 50 Shades, be like, guys.
Yeah.
I think it's so funny because you just think of, oh God, that must have been so awkward, or what was actually going on in that moment.
Right.
You know. It's but yeah.
Sam, are you disappointed that they haven't written that for Jamie to gain 40 pounds yet in an upcoming season? Are you ready to kind of like?
Fat Jamie definitely needs to make an appearance at some point, and. I've been trying to push that, but you know we've got time. You know we're about.
We got nothing but time.
We got nothing but time. We have obviously got a season four, so I think maybe he could make an appearance there.
When's the last time you had a donut? Let's be honest with each other.
I don't know actually.
It's so good.
No,
it's so annoying because
what's the worst thing you've ever seen him eat?
There was a bowl of guacamole last night, and
yeah, but you shared yours, and I had one for myself.
Did actually?
Yes. Yeah.
Did you go to the gym this morning?
I did.
Oh. Yeah, like this is the thing. So we go to set, right? And you know, you get in at like 5:30, 6 in the morning, and I'm like bleary eyed, and you know, coffee the size of my head, and Sam's like, yeah, just been to the gym, you know, and then he goes to the gym after work as well. You know, it's a tough person to be around.
I'm eating donuts in the gym though.
That's the secret. He closes the door, turns out the lights, and he's just eating donuts. Yeah.
I really hope I find out he's like a secret like junk food midnight eater.
Totally.
Or something.
The tell-all book. It's just in his sleep, someone's exercising him. Here at Comic-Con, we're talking about a bunch of different things that everybody's kind of talking about. Game of Thrones, are either of you into Game of Thrones?
Yeah, big fan.
How do you think Game of Thrones should end? Predictions as we kind of come towards the end?
Well, they're not far now, are they? I mean, if I'm totally honest, I haven't seen the first episode of the new season, so I'm really excited to see that.
Cool.
But I'm a big fan of the show, and so is Katrina.
Should win.
The dragon wins.